Money, money, money. It's so funny in a rich man's world. Or so goes the famous song. Oftentimes, spaceflight and other activities in space are seen as a drain of money instead of a profit-making activity. Yet, what if I were to tell you that space may not only be a way for individuals and societies to make money, but also maybe the way for us humans to generate money and material resources? But Tom, you may ask, don't you see those big expensive rockets consuming all that expensive rocket fuel? Don't those cost money? And the answer to that question is yes, they do cost money, and lots of it too. But an often overlooked resource exists in space that we humans have not tapped yet, that may make the quadrillionaire corporation or person, asteroids. Yes, I'm talking about those big rocks in space. The way to get rich in space, or really rich in any way, is to mine those asteroids. Why are we able to make money in asteroids? Well, it's because those asteroids contain minerals that are used in many industries on Earth. These minerals include precious metals that can be brought back to Earth and used as components for electronics. Likewise, they contain iron group metals that can be used for space construction. Finally, there is also ice on those asteroids that may be used to create rocket fuel in space after being turned into water. But first, I'd like to talk about the first type of materials that we can gain from asteroids, precious metals that are rare and running out on Earth. Minerals that can be mined from asteroids include cobalt, platinum, antimony, zinc, nickel, and gold. Some of these minerals are expected to run out on Earth within the next 50 to 60 years due to increased consumption in developing and developed nations. That's all fine and good, you may say. But what we want to know is how rich are we going to get from asteroid mining? And that's a question I'll be glad to answer. To put things into perspective, the asteroid Ryugu is expected to have a value of about $83 billion and an estimated profit of $30 billion from mining. And this is from just one asteroid alone. And this asteroid only has a diameter of 0.87 kilometers. Now, let's take some time to talk about the real big money. How much money can we get from all the asteroids in the asteroid belt? And the answer to that question is a lot. In the over 1 million asteroids in the asteroid belt, there are about $700 quintillion worth of resources. And just to give you a sense of just how big this number is, this is over 7 million times the entire world's economic output in the year of 2018. Or to put it in another perspective, this is about $100 billion worth of value for every person alive today. By now, you probably agree with me that space is the way to get rich. But it gets even better from here. With proper space conservation techniques, we can make it so that we, as a human society, can get rich for thousands of years, or almost forever. Now, some of you might be thinking, why not just mine all these asteroids right away and bring it back all to Earth tomorrow so that everyone can become multi-billionaires within the next few decades? Why do we have to conserve these resources? And the sad answer to that is inflation. According to basic economics, the value of something is based on how useful it is to humanity or the demand and how little of it there is or the supply. While the precious metals I described earlier will always remain useful to humanity because of their usage as electronics and industrial components, they are so valuable today because they are in short supply. Thus, if we were to suddenly dump so much of these precious metals into humanity's economy, we would see an oversupply of these resources. The result of that would be that these resources would lose their value and would no longer be worth the $700 quintillion they are today by our society. Furthermore, we will begin consuming these resources at a much faster rate than before because they became so cheap. As such, if we're not careful, having all these precious metals at our disposal at once would mean that we would use them up so quickly that we may return to a position of scarcity again within a few hundred years. As such, the principle here is balance. We want to mine enough of these asteroids so that we significantly bolster our world's economy and potentially have enough resources to eradicate poverty as a society if the resource allocation is managed properly. However, we do not want to mine so much of these asteroids that we make them lose their value and overconsume them. As such, we will have to practice space conservation, perhaps taking out enough asteroids every year to triple our world's economy, enough to potentially eradicate poverty, but not so much that we devalue our resources. And as mentioned earlier, an added benefit of space conservation is that we can become rich for thousands and thousands of years. But because this channel is named The Futurist, Tom, let's shift directions from how rich we can get from mining asteroids to what the future world will look like once we begin mining asteroids. First and foremost, I'll be assuming a 100% efficient global response to the import of precious metals from asteroids. Of course, this assumes that we have one human government deciding these factors, a topic that I'll discuss in a future video. The future world will first and foremost see the end of sketchy and environmentally damaging earth mining. The reason why I call earth mining sketchy is because it is oftentimes done in the poorest regions of the world where much child labor is used. However, asteroid mining, on the other hand, will be done entirely by robots. Likewise, because earth mining destroys ecosystems and forests, it is environmentally degrading. So beyond making people rich, asteroid mining is also good for the world because it saves the environment and the children. Beyond that, we will see a complete overhaul of the Earth's industries. Operating on the assumption that Earth will adapt perfectly to asteroid mining, I predict the three following changes. Earth will become an agricultural hub, the asteroid belt will become a mining hub, and space colonies will become a manufacturing hub. Well folks, that's all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please consider liking and subscribing. The code for this video is alumni.